5月25日晨,
with the concerted efforts of China and ASEAN countries, the situation in South China Sea is cooling down and showing positive signs of development. But what the U.S. has done is causing severe disruptions to this process of dialogue and consultation. It will bring itself no good while hurting others.
For the first time since President Trump took office, an American guided missile destroyer sailed within 12 nautical miles of one of China's man-made islands in the South China Sea. Early Thursday, the USS Dewey passed near the aptly named Mischief Reef in the Spratly Chain, one of three islands built by China in the past 3 years containing a runway and military fortifications. Beijing strongly protested the U.S. action, deploying two Chinese warships as a warning, urging the U.S. destroyer to change course.
We urge the U.S. to correct its mistake immediately and stop provocative actions that hurt China's sovereignty and security interests.
The Pentagon would not confirm the USS Dewey's exact course, saying freedom of navigation operations, quote, are not about any one country, nor are they about making political statements. The Chinese have built a total of 7 man-made islands in the South China Sea since 2014. $5 trillion of trade passed through these waters each year. Vietnam, Malaysia, the Philippines, Brunei, and Taiwan have all challenged Chinese claims in the region. The U.S. Navy sent warships near the islands 3 times in 2016. Last year, an international tribunal rejected many of China's claims to the islands. The U.S. Navy has not sailed near these contested islands since October. A recent New York Times story questioned whether the Trump administration had given up on these operations while trying to work with China on the North Korea problem. Secretary of State Rex Tillerson says China has been helpful threatening North Korea with sanctions if it didn't change its behavior.
They confirmed to us that they had requested the regime conduct no further nuclear test.
In Washington, the chief of naval operations was questioned about today's operation.
I'm still curious about the timing. Why now?
I would suppose that there's an implicit dimension to your question that these are somehow confrontational or something like that, and I would say that they're exactly the opposite.
China's Navy missile destroyer has identified the U.S. Navy destroyer and gave warnings until it left.
The U.S. says it carries out freedom of navigation operations by sending Navy ships and aircraft near the disputed waters. Their operations aim to demonstrate the right to fly and sail through what it considers to be international waters and airspace.
Following President Xi Jinping's meeting with Trump in April, relations between China and the U.S. has been progressing relatively smooth. The Defense Ministry has now strongly protested the U.S. patrol, while the U.S. declines to confirm details of the operation. Now the question is, where would the bilateral military relations go?
The naval move on Wednesday was first reported by the Wall Street Journal, but the U.S. declined to confirm it. The U.S. Defense Department said that their forces operate in the Asia-Pacific region on a daily basis, including the South China Sea. It also said the summaries of these operations would be released in its annual report, but not anytime sooner. The Defense Ministry highlighted these recent activities in the waters and said operations of such kind would only urge China to safeguard its sovereignty and security.
We ask the U.S. side to take measures to correct the mistakes and make positive efforts to the development of bilateral military relations. The misdeeds of the U.S. Navy only urge China to further enhance its capacity and safeguard national sovereignty and security.
The Defense Ministry reiterated that the two militaries are currently at an important period of development, and healthy and stable bilateral relations are to the common benefit of both sides.